Everyone, as I promised that I am going to make one more video on multiplication and probability. So here is this that probability of hitting a target, probability of hitting a target at first, second and third shots are, so probability that hitting a target in the first shot, that is 3 divided by 5, probability that hitting the target in the second shot, that is 2 divided by 5, and probability that is hitting the target in third shot, that is 3 divided by 4. So first one I am doing, just check, now they are independent events, because first shot if I hit or not, that doesn't affect my second shot. Similarly it is going in the third shot, right? So these are independent event. Please be very careful about this thing. So now first case, that probability that one hit registered, only one hit registered. So how this thing is happening? So one hit registered can be done by the first hit, so that time second hit and third hit is not registered. It can be done by the second hit, that time first hit and third hit is not registered. It can be done by the third hit, that time first hit and second hit is not registered. So after this is right, as they are independent event, so as they are independent event, so I can write this line as P H1 into H2 complement into H3 complement plus P H1 complement P H2 into P H3 complement and then plus P H1 complement P H2 complement into P H3, right? So I know P H1 is 3 divided by 5. So from there, if I will calculate what will be P H1 complement, that is 2 divided by 5. P H2 complement will be 3 divided by 5, and P H3 complement, that will be 1 divided by 4. So now if I will put this value over there, what was P H1? PH1 is 3 divided by 5, PH2 complement is also 3 divided by 5, H3 complement is 1 by 4. H1 complement is 2 divided by 5, H2 is 2 divided by 5, and the last one is 1 divided by 4. Next one, H1 complement is 2 divided by 5, H2 complement is 3 divided by 5. And the last one is 3 divided by 4. This line of sum I was talking about, don't cancel out this 2, 2 and 4. Because if you will do this calculation, still you have to take this same LCM. So better the LCM is 5, 25 is 400. So 9 plus 4 plus, which is 9, 18 divided by 100. So the answer is 31 divided by 100. So this is a mutual independent event. Now the same sum, if I will say the same sum, next one, probability target gets hit. So target gets hit, or the same question can come, probability of at least one target gets hit. So at least one target gets hit or target gets hit. What's the meaning of target gets? Can happen by first attempt or second attempt or third attempt, or first attempt, second attempt, or second attempt, third attempt, or third attempt, first attempt, or can be hit by all this attempt, right? So for this case, it is at least one target get registered. So at least when we have at least one target registered, first I'm going to find out probability of no hit gets registered. What is the meaning of no hit get registered? That is probability of H1 into H2 complement, H1 complement, H2 complement into H3 complement, which is actually 2 divided by 5 into 3 divided by 5 into 1 divided by 4, 6 divided by 100. So if I further simplify, so what will be the probability that target gets hit? Probability of target gets hit will be 1 minus this, that is 94 by 100, answer is 47 by 50. Is it fine, all of you? So next question is, a bag contains 4 white and 2 black balls. So next question, bag contains 4 white and 2 black balls, and the second bag contains that 3 white and 5 black balls. If one ball is drawn from each bag, find the probability that both are white. So first case, probability of both white ball. First case, one ball I am drawing from these 6 balls. How many ways? 6C1. And out of that one white ball I have, that is 4C1, right? Both white, these are independent events. So second white ball will come from 3C1 divided by 8C1. That is 4 divided by 6 into 3 divided by 8. So answer is 1 divided by 4, right? Next one, both are black. Similar way, you can proceed for both are black. I think you can do it. Probability of both black. So it can be 2 divided by 6 into 5 divided by 8. Similar way, if you calculate, it will be 5 divided by 24. Right? Next case is given that one is white and one is black. So what is probability of one white and one black? Now please be very careful in this case. We are drawing, one box drawn from the each bag. So I am doing for one white and one black. So what is the case of, is the first case this one white and this one black. So 4C1 into 5C1 divided by 6C1 into 8C1, that's the first case. And second case, it can be this white is coming and this black is coming, divide by same thing, 6C1 into 8C1. So if you further calculate, you will get 4, 5 is 20 plus 6, 26, divide by 48, if I divide by 2, it will be 38 divided by 24, right? Next one I'm going to do, this is the last one I'm going to do for right now. That is A and B, but if you have doubt, please write me in the comment box so that further I can proceed. A and B throw a pair of dice alternately. A wins the game if he gets a total of 7 and 8. So what is the probability of A winning first? 7 and 8. 7 comes like 6, 1, 5, 2, 4, 3, 3, 4, 2, 5 and 1, 6. And 8 is coming how many way? 2, 6, 3, 5. Just check gradually. I am increasing 1. I am decreasing 1. So 6, 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 plus 5. So probability of A winning is 11 divided by 36, right? B wins the game if he gets a total of 10. What is the probability of getting a total of 10? It can be 6, 4, 5, 5. And 4, 6, that is 3 out of 36. I'll keep it like this. They are throwing the dice alternately and it's continuing. What is the probability that B wins the game? So it may happen that, and one more thing is mentioned, that if A starts the game, so it may come that A is starting the game, A couldn't qualify, then B wins the game. That is the probability of B wins the game. Second case, A started, A couldn't, B started, B couldn't, A started, A couldn't, and B qualified to win the game. Third case, A couldn't, B couldn't, A could not, B could not, A could not, and then B, right? So these are the independent events. So I can write it as A complement into PB. This will be probability of A complement, probability of B complement, probability of A complement into PB, like this. Right? So further just check, this is an infinite GP. The formula is infinite GP A divided by 1 minus R. If you remember the formula of infinite GP, this is the thing. Probability of A is 11 by 36. So probability of A complement will be 25 by 36. And probability of B complement will be 33 by 36. If I put this value and calculate over here, calculation, this will be the answer. So A starts the game and A gets either 7 or 8 to win. These two get 10 to win. So if it continues, this will be the probability. Thank you.